there was one scene right at the beginning of the picture where Glenda Jackson is on this, on location in this house in Oxfordshire, and she's got an iron bath on the table, and she's washing the baby. And her husband, played by Christopher Gable, comes in, and the baby has to be crying. And Christopher Gable, who's the father, says, "Oh, sing, little blackbird, sing." And Glenda carries on, and, you know, there's a scene that follows. But we had to have a very young baby. Well, my first granddaughter had just been born, and she was 4 months old. And I spoke to Claire and Matthew, her father, and I said, how would you like Amy to be in a movie? And I explained what was going to happen. And they were both very pleased and thrilled about it. And so they came on set with Amy, and she was put into the bathtub, and Glenda was lovely with her, and we started shooting. Well, what I should say here is that in the years since I'd worked with Ken before, he'd become the camera operator. And he operated everything on a slip head, and this was a tracking shot, starting looking down on Amy in the bath and tracking back to reveal Glenda Jackson bathing her, and then Christopher Gable comes in. Well, we did a few takes, and Amy started off fine. She was gurgling away because she liked the bath. And after about three or four takes, she started to get a bit grumpy. And we kept on shooting. And the longer we shot, the more angry she became. And the problem was that Ken couldn't get the tilt up right. And he had this, I mean, he was obsessed with headroom. And if he didn't get the headroom on a shot perfectly right, he would go again. He would just say, "Oh, I'm just making an adjustment on the camera." We'd do another take, regardless of the performance. And so we were continually doing this tracking shot, pulling back from Amy to a wider shot. It was 18 takes before Ken got the camera work right, by which time Amy was purple with rage. And although it was good for the scene because she was yelling her head off, when I came to grade it, I had this problem of starting on a purple baby coming up and having to have the correct skin tone for Glenda. But it was my granddaughter's debut into cinema. And it was quite a coincidence because her father was an actor and his parents were both actors. So she had become a third generation actress, if you like. And also, you know, my daughter Claire is third generation in cinema because Claire went to the National Film School where she graduated as a director, and that's where she met Matthew. So a lot of things kind of came together there. And I enjoyed doing the picture. And we had a lovely score by Carl Davis. And it was good fun. It was good to work with Ken again. I did some more commercials with him and another film for television, part of a series called Dusk Before Fireworks, which we shot at Shepperton. And again, he insisted on operating. But if he got to a shot that was a bit too difficult for him, he'd say, "Oh, well, why don't you do this one, you see?" So I'd get the geared head out. It's usually a tracking shot. I'd get the geared head out and I'd take a shot and then he'd take over again. See, he didn't like relinquishing the operating, but he'd also, in the process, he'd become the writer as well as the director and sometimes the producer. So he was wearing too many hats, I'm afraid. But he was a lot of fun, great sense of humor. I like Ken.